kind of, I think the student body's doing that. But every year, I get text messages from people, like friends, who actually know us, and surely would know by now that when it's printed in a newspaper, it's not true. And they're like, oh my god, congrats on Strictly, and I'm like, no. But yes, I would love to do it though, but not this year. All right, yes. Besides Beyoncé or Celine, who would I like a duet with? I love Lady Antebellum. I love Carrie Underwood. The song I sang earlier, she wrote that song. I would love to sing with her. And who else do I love? Kelly Clarkson.
Yes.
Okay. I love Kelly Clarkson. So yeah, there's a few. Is that good enough? All right. Anyone up towards the back? Yes. Oh, thank you. Oh, bless you. Thank you. That's very kind. Bless you. Yes, sir. You had your hand up, didn't you? Yes. Yeah, I mean, it's nearly 10 years ago now, and I've changed a lot since then. I've grown up quite a bit, and I have very fond memories of the show. I don't know how well I would cope with it now, with the experience I've got. I don't know whether I would be able to go back and do it again. I think my blessing at the time was that I was so naive, and I was a huge fan of the show, and I was very excited to be a part of it, and I was like, oh my god, I'm on the X Factor. I don't think I would feel that going back now. And that's not because I had a bad experience, I just think with age, you get a little bit wiser, and your eyes are open to a few more things that maybe you didn't notice at the time. I was working really busy over Christmas, and I planned to take about 2 months off before my tour started. I think that was the first time I would have come here actually on my Set This All Alive tour. So I had about 2.5 months off, and in the middle of that, I was going skiing with all my family. And it was probably about the third day of the holiday, and I was sitting in a cafe, and a producer from X Factor, who I work with actually, sent us a text message, and she said, I've just seen on your Instagram, or Twitter at the time, I don't know what it was. She said, you're in Austria, is that right? And I said, yeah. She said, basically, we're doing this new Channel 4 TV show, and all of the celebrities are injured. It's true story. And she said, we've got nobody, she said, all of the stand-ins, because basically when you do a TV show, like I'm a Celebrity or anything, there's also celebrities that are thrown out, and they're waiting behind the scenes to go in at any point, should anything happen, obviously for the voting things. And so she said, everybody who was due to be a stand-in is now injured. She said, we need somebody who can come in and start filming tomorrow, who can ski without training. And so I'm sat in a cafe having a relaxing cup of coffee. And I thought, well, that sounds great. I'm on a ski holiday anyways. It'll just be like an extended holiday. Little did I know, they were going to have us hurtling down ice trees and skeleton works. They kind of missed that bit out, you know, in the negotiations of the management. And when I got there, I realised that it wasn't just a skiing show, and I was like, wow. But I was actually one of the only people on that show that left with just bruises. Everybody else had like broken fingers, feet, legs, everything. And I think because I went in so last minute, psychologically I didn't have time to freak myself out. And I think it was my saviour. They'd been filming for months, and they'd hype them up as they do for television. So much that by the time they got on the slopes, they were like this, like petrified. But it was an amazing show. And I wish they had filmed me and Sunita in the bar every night after the live show, because I think that would be more interesting than the TV show. Yes. What got me into singing? I hated standing in front of an audience when I up until I was about 14. How that has changed. I hated it. I had no confidence as a performer. I went to a drama club when I was younger. and I would always be the one that would stand in the back. And whenever the school choir, I would mind, because I would be petrified anyone would hear us sing. And when I was about 14, my family are huge karaoke fans, and they all think we're the best singer in the family, but it's clearly me. No, I'm kidding. And they all fight for the microphone. Again, that would make for an interesting television show. Mum still asks us now, we sing on karaoke together, and she grabs the mic for all the good bits of the song, and then passes me it for all the rubbish bits. I'm an argument mid-song. I will post that on Instagram one day, if you're
good. Oh, yes.
But basically, I just started doing local karaoke gigs, and family parties I would get on. And then before I knew it, I was on the internet. And that kind of, even then I was still really, if you look back at some of the stuff, I was really shy. And it was kind of just like, this is your opportunity, go for it. And that's kind of how it started. Yeah. All right.